नमस्कार दोस्तों, जैसा कि आप जानते हैं कि हम लोग चर्चा कर रहे हैं डेमोक्रेसी डेवलपमेंट एंड वायलेंस, इस पर एक लेक्चर सीरीज हम लोगों ने शुरू किया है कल से। कल हम लोगों ने डेमोक्रेसी डेवलपमेंट और वायलेंस को वेस्टर्न फिलॉसफी और इंडियन फिलॉसफी में किस तरह से डिफाइन करते हैं, इस पर चर्चा किए थे। आज हम लोग चर्चा करेंगे उत्तर पूर्व में इन संस्थाओं को किस प्रकार से विकास हुआ है और किस तरह से अभी का वर्तमान परिदृश्य है उसको समझने की कोशिश करेंगे, और क्या संकल्पना, क्या परिस्थिति है जो आगे अनफोल्ड हो रही है। अभी कुछ वहाँ के घटक दल हैं जो सरकार से, केंद्रीय सरकार से बात कर रहे हैं और शांति की प्रक्रिया की ओर भी बढ़ रहे हैं। तो लोकतंत्र किस तरह से मजबूत हुई है, विकास की प्रक्रिया आगे बढ़ी है, और जो वायलेंस था वो भी इधर कुछ दिनों में कुछ उसमें कमी आई है। इन सब चीज़ों पर आज चर्चा करेंगे। उस पर चर्चा के लिए स्टूडियो में उपस्थित हैं डॉक्टर सुशील के सिंह। आप जनसंचार और मास कम्युनिकेशन के गुरु जम्बेश्वर यूनिवर्सिटी में अध्यापक हैं और साथ ही उत्तर पूर्व के घटनाओं पर पैनी नज़र रखते हैं। तो हम लोग उम्मीद करते हैं कि इनका नॉलेज और अनुभव जो उस इलाके को देखने को मिला है, समझने को मिला है, उससे हम लोग को लाभ मिलेगा। इसी उम्मीद के साथ डॉक्टर सिंह को आमंत्रित करता हूँ कि वे अपना व्याख्यान शुरू करें। वेलकम सर।
थैंक यू अमरेंद्र जी। आज का चर्चा का विषय है लोकतंत्र, विकास और हिंसा, जो हमारे जो पूर्वोत्तर राज्यों में जो आज की संदर्भ में चल रही है। तो ये जो टॉपिक है डेमोक्रेसी डेवलपमेंट एंड वायलेंस इन द नॉर्थ ईस्ट रीजन्स, तो ये यहाँ पे इस टॉपिक में जैसे हमें पता है कि ये यहाँ पे तीन अलग अलग जो है चीज़ें हैं कि हम जो हम अलग अलग संदर्भ में हम जाना चाहते हैं कि जो एक तो लोकतंत्र क्या है और विकास का संदर्भ और वायलेंस, ये हम पहले हम इन तीनों को हम अलग अलग संदर्भ में हम इसको चर्चा करेंगे, फिर इसके बाद हम इसको हमारे देश के संदर्भ में हम इसको फिर चर्चा करेंगे। फिर हम है कि आज हम पूरा कोशिश करेंगे कि नॉर्थ ईस्टर्न रीजन्स जो भारत के जो पूर्वोत्तर राज्य हैं इसमें आज की क्या स्थिति है और ये जो आज की स्थिति है वो कैसी बनी थी और वो आगे कैसे बनना चाहिए और कैसे बनते रहेंगे, ये आज हम इसी डिस्कशन के दौरान हम इसको बातचीत करेंगे। तो ये हम सब जानते हैं कि जो डेमोक्रेसी है, लोकतंत्र जो हम बोलते हैं, लोकतंत्र एक ऐसा जो है सरकार का जो नीति है, मतलब जो हम हमारी जो सरकार जो हम जो है गवर्नमेंट है, इसी से हम इसका जो हम इसका अर्थ है कि गवर्नमेंट ऑफ द पीपल फॉर द पीपल एंड बाय द पीपल। इसका मतलब ये अगर इसके हम अर्थ से चले हैं, इसके मीनिंग से चले तो ये लोकतंत्र है, जो लोग जो है आप इसको एक जो सरकार जो हम जो लोगों की जो सरकार जो है लोगों की सरकार है, लोगों ने ही बनाया है और लोगों के लिए है और लोगों के संदर्भ में ही वो सरकार बनाया है। तो डेमोक्रेसी जो है ये हम सब जानते हैं कि ये पूरे दुनिया भर में ये दिस इज़ वन ऑफ द बेस्ट फॉर्म्स ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट्स। तो आज की समय में हर देशों में, लगभग दुनिया के हर देशों में ये जो सरकार की जो नीति जो है वो अपनाया हुआ है। और ये हम ये जो सरकार जो है ये इसका अगर हम ये इसका माइनस एंड प्लस पॉइंट्स हम अगर हम बात करेंगे तो ये जो माइनस एंड प्लस पॉइंट जो है ये आपको ये सारे निकालने के बाद जो इसका जो टोटल आउटकम जो है, जो होलिस्टिक इसका जो रिजल्ट जो है ये है कि हमारी जो गुड गवर्नेंस की बात है। तो आज हमने हमारी देश को, इंडिया को एक इंटरनेशनल में पर्सपेक्टिव में हमें एक बार देखना चाहिए शुरू में कि हमारी जो देश है आज पूरे इंटरनेशनल पर्सपेक्टिव में कहाँ पे खड़े हुए हैं और कहाँ पे है, मतलब जो है बिकॉज आज की जो युग जो है, आज के समय जो है ये है पावर की, इकोनॉमिक डेवलपमेंट की, न्यूक्लियर पावर की और जो तकनीकी जो है एडवांसमेंट्स है, जो तकनीकी चेंजेस है, जो इसके आप जो साइंटिफिक प्रोसेस जो है हम इसमें हम वो है सारे उलझे हुए हैं सारे देश जो है। तो हमारी देश आज की किस स्थिति पर है, तो एक बार तो हमें नेशनल पर्सपेक्टिव जो पूरे देश के पर्सपेक्टिव से हमें देखना पड़ेगा, क्योंकि जो देश है देश के लोगों से इसकी पहचान होते हैं कि आज आपको, हम सबको पता है कि आज हमारे देश में 125 करोड़ लोग रहते हैं। तो ये एक बहुत बड़ा देश है, भारत देश जो है एक सब कंटिनेंट है, और एक देश इस सब कंटिनेंट में 125 करोड़ लोग रहते हैं, और ये एक ही धर्म की या एक ही भाषा की या एक ही देश उसकी एक ही उसकी वो कास्ट की या क्रिक की कम्युनिटी क्लान एक ही नहीं होती। इसमें अलग अलग वो है, कास्ट है, क्रिक है, कम्युनिटी है, क्लैंस है, एंड देयर आर सो मेनी एथनिक ग्रुप्स, एथनिक पीपल्स, लोकलाइज पीपल, सो मेनी रीजन्स, देन सो मेनी वी हैव सो मेनी लैंग्वेजेस, सो मेनी से यू कैन से रिलीजन, कल्चर एंड एंड एनवायरनमेंट बेस्ड ऑन द जोग्राफिकल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशंस। तो ये अलग अलग जो है, ये सारे हमें मिल करके जो पूरे जो है, हम इसको हम भारत देश बोलते हैं। तो भारत देश की एक खास बात जो है, इंडिया की जो एक खास बात है कि वी आर नोन इन द वर्ल्ड एज ए कंट्री ऑफ यूनिटी इन डाइवर्सिटी। तो देर आर सो मेनी डाइवर्स कल्चर्स, डाइवर्स लैंग्वेजेस, डाइवर्स रिलीजन्स, डाइवर्स पीपल, डाइवर्स क्लाइंट्स, क्रीड्स एंड एथनिक्स एंड सो मेनी थिंग्स। तो इसमें जो लोकतंत्र जो है, आप अगर हम अगर आप हम इस माह पे कि इस डेमोक्रेसी में, इस गवर्नमेंट्स में क्या है कि वी आर एक एक जो है, जो फेडरलिज्म जो है, कि वो सारे जगह की, सारे रीजन्स की, स्टेट्स की मिल करके जो बनाते हैं, दिस इज कॉल्ड द फेडरलिज्म। तो इसमें जो जो अगर अगर देखा जाए तो दिस वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द सेंट्रल गवर्नेंस और द फेडरल स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द गवर्नेंस। तो व्हाट हैपन हियर इज दिस इज ए कंपोजिट स्ट्रक्चर, दिस फेडरल स्ट्रक्चर इज ए कंपोजिट स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ, आई मीन कंसिस्टिंग ऑफ ऑल द स्टेट्स ऑफ द कंट्री। सो हेयर इट कम्स ऑल द कंट्रीज लाइक वेदर इट इज हरियाणा, पंजाब और से आसाम, मणिपुर, नागालैंड, मिजोरम और से अदर स्टेट्स लाइक आंध्र प्रदेश, कर्नाटका, एवरीथिंग। सो ये सारे मिल करके एक देश बनते हैं। तो दैट मीन्स एवरी स्टेट ऑफ द कंट्री एज ए कंट्रीब्यूशन टुवार्ड्स द गवर्नेंस, एंड एवरी स्टेट शुड पार्टिसिपेट इन काइंड ऑफ ए गुड गवर्नेंस। सो इससे क्या होगा कि सी वी कैन गेट सो मेनी एडवांटेजेस, लाइक वी आर इन ए कंट्री एंड थ्रू द होल वर्ल्ड वी आर नोन बाय द नेम ऑफ द कंट्री। सो ये जो कंट्री जो हमारी जो है, इंडिया जो है, तो दिस इज नोन बाय ए कॉन्ग्लोमरेशन ऑफ द स्टेट, जो सारे राज्यों में मिल करके, सारे एथनिक ग्रुप्स, सारे वो रीजनल ग्रुप्स, सारे जो रिलीजनल ग्रुप्स, सारे कल्चरल ग्रुप्स, लैंग्वेजेस ग्रुप, सारे मिलके इंडिया बनते हैं। सो दिस इज़ वन काइंड ऑफ थिंग वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट हियर। एंड इन डेमोक्रेसी, सो सिंस वी हैव ए काइंड ऑफ फेडरलिस्टिक स्ट्रक्चर एंड वी शुड पार्टिसिपेट इन द गवर्नेंस, बिकॉज दिस ऑल्सो इंक्लूड्स अवर ऑन गवर्नेंस। सपोज इफ वी बिलोंग टू ए पर्टिकुलर स्टेट एंड वी सी वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट दैट पर्टिकुलर गवर्नेंस, एंड गवर्नेंस मीन्स सी वी दिस इज फॉर आवर सेल्व्स, दिस इज फॉर वी पीपल। सो इन द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ इंडिया, द डायरेक्टिव प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ स्टेट पॉलिसी, इट स्टार्ट्स विद वी द पीपल ऑफ इंडिया। सो नंबर वन थिंग इज एवरीबॉडी विच बिलोंग टू दिस कंट्री शुड हैव ए कंसेप्ट ऑफ बिलोंगिंगनेस और से द फीलिंग ऑफ सिटीजनशिप ऑफ द कंट्री। सो इफ वी हैव दैट काइंड ऑफ फीलिंग, देन वी कैन कंट्रीब्यूट इन आवर गवर्नेंस। सो गवर्नेंस में क्या कि सी एवरीबॉडी हैज़ ए चांस, एवरीबॉडी कैन बिकम से पार्ट ऑफ द गवर्नेंस, बिकॉज सी डेमोक्रेसी बाई इट्स बाई इट्स सेंट्रलिटी, बाई इट्स होलिस्टिक मीनिंग इज द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ द पीपल, फॉर द पीपल एंड बाई द पीपल। सो एवरीबॉडी, एवरी पीपल इन दिस कंट्री हैज़ ए चांस फॉर द गवर्नेंस। एंड नेक्स्ट वी आर टॉकिंग हियर इज द कंसेप्ट ऑफ द डेवलपमेंट, बिकॉज एज आई सेड कि वी शुड एज ए कंट्री वी शुड कीप आवर सेल्फ इन द इंटरनेशनल परस्पेक्टिव। सो वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द डेवलपमेंट हियर, बिकॉज सी वंस वी हैव ए गुड गवर्नेंस एंड सी वी हैव ए गुड डेमोक्रेसी और गुड प्रैक्टिस ऑफ डेमोक्रेसी इन द कंट्री, और वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द स्टेबल गवर्नमेंट्स और से गवर्नमेंट विद अकाउंटेबिलिटी, with say all the democratic features like the good electoral process, election system, the participatory system in the government, and we are talking about the economic freedom also. So there are a few things which we talk about the democracy. So if we look into these things, like say, number one, in order to form an accountable or good government, we should have a very good kind of electoral process. So electoral process is, if we have a pre and fair election process, then everybody has the pre and fair chance of participate in the governance. And it in democracy, again, government is also known, or the country is also known by its economic independence or economic freedom. So another another stand in a democratic state is the kind of economic freedom we should have in a country. So these are basic features of democracy. Then if we have the good governance, we have the free and fair election, then we have the, say, economic freedom, then we can think about the development process. Because development, in development, what you see, again, there is a misconception about development, because development is a paradigm which changes from time to time. But for me, development should be something that every citizen of the country should have this, should get this democratic rights. Or say we can have, we are talking about this good governance and say a free and fair election, then economic power. So if every person gets the these three features, or say the basic features of democracy, then there is a chance of development. And see, when one becomes independent, when one becomes has economic power, then we can think about its existence. Now, in India, what is happening is the problem is we have so many say people. We have as I said, we have around 125 crore people. So, if and see, due to its say, there are various other backdrops of democracy that leads to the development of this country. So that cannot be categorized to one particular region or particular group of people or particular religion or structure like this. So everybody has contributed either to the negative development or the positive development of a country. So that we'll discuss later. Then if we understand these two things, like the democracy helps in development, or development, see, if we are not practiced democracy in its true spirit, then it can lead to negative development or positive development. Because from here we can see, if one has given the rights, the basic rights, the right to living, right to speech, freedom of property, freedom of and so many things. But one does not get in a democracy, then it becomes something violative of the system. And that violative of the system towards the development and democracy of the governments or the country, that leads to most of the times the violence. So this is one kind of synthesis where violence starts in a country. Now we're coming in the context of the Northeast region. As I said, our country is a country of diverse kinds of cultures, diverse kinds of people, diverse kinds of languages, cultural context, ethnic groups, etc., etc. And there are so many diversities in things. Although we proudly say we are a country of unity and diversity. Now, if we look at the the whole Indian perspective, like we divide this the country into some regions, like the central region, then we have northern region, western region, southern region, and the eastern region, and then the northeast region. And where by geographical status also, we have so many different geographical regions that creates so many diversity in environmental cultures or environmental impacts. Now, what is the problem with the northeast countries, आई मीन नॉर्थ स्टेट्स से लाइक मिजोरम नागालैंड मणिपुर आसाम स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम द से दिस सिलीगुड़ी कॉरिडर दैट वी कट ऑफ एज अ नॉर्थ ईस्ट रीजन पार्ट ऑफ द नॉर्थ ईस्ट रीजन हियर वी आई मीन द पीपल ऑफ इंडिया इन इन द अदर स्टेट्स वी हैव ए से लाइक सिमिलरिटी इन languages or say the words we spoken we used to speak or say our see language when there is a similarity of languages then there are similarity of cultures then if similarity of culture is there then we one become known to others then one become known to others then there is a establishment of relationship then it becomes known and relatives and then we belong to one common platform now In the Northeast region, Northeast region is such a place that there are so many diverse ethnic groups. Because there are these ethnic groups in the other parts of the country, they are not so diverse as in the Northeast states. Because like Assam, there are see this is so many. Innumerable number of say ethnic groups, ethnic class, communities, clans are there. And then we have other states like Nagaland, Manipur, Mizoram, Tripura, Arunachal Pradesh. So yeah, all one problem is the whole Northeast India has a problem of features of the appearance or ethnic groups with other parts of the country. And what is the reality behind this is again there is differences internal differences again among the ethnic groups in this part of the country also so that leads to sometimes what you call the miscommunication process because we cannot have the similar language we cannot have the similar culture we cannot have the similar religion then we become diverse and we are in the untalkative terms because see when we don't share our jo bhasha jo hum bolte hain hum ek hi bhasha nahi bolte alag alag bhasha bolte hain aur alag alag religion ki hai alag alag jo hamari jo hai culture hai to isse hame jo relationship banne mein there are so many difficulties Like say we can discuss other things because historically and geographically as well we have a very different kind of people in the Northeast and the Northeast region the problem from starting from is like the it started from British India we can get a synthesis from the British India. And when British left the country, there was a provision of any states can, can become the part of the Indian dominion or not like this. But this particular region, the Northeast region, was even during those times also there was less developed. This is less developed among the Asiatic regions also, because. There was, right from the beginning, the people are so confined to particular ethnic groups. They are so confined to particular language, particular culture. So there is nothing kind of expansion in those days, and even now the people in the Northeast states they love to speak their own language, and if they are forced to speak say other. Language like Hindi and any other language, that becomes kind of unadaptation process for the people. So there is a problem of communication between the Northeast states, because from the mainland country where the mainland country means. The whole India subtracting the Northeast region. So this mainland countries they have a common culture, common language. Like Hindi is spoken in say the entire north of the country. Then it is spoken in the west side of the country. And okay, this is a language spoken throughout the country. So when see when we have so many diverse cultures, so many problems, we have to speak one language, whether we speak the international language English or we speak the जो राष्ट्रभाषा हम बोलते हैं जो हिंदी जो है ये हमें बोलना पड़ेगा बिकॉज आवर प्रॉब्लम कैन बी कैटेगराइज एज अ प्रॉब्लम ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन द प्रॉब्लम इन द नॉर्थ ईस्ट इज अ प्रॉब्लम ऑफ आई मीन इट 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 वी कैन हैव अ सिंथेसाइज फ्रॉम इट इट स्टार्ट फ्रॉम द कम्युनिकेशन प्रोसेस बिकॉज वी द पीपल इन द नॉर्थ ईस्ट रीजन दे आर कन्फाइंड टू एज आई सेड दे आर पर्टिकुलर लैंग्वेज और दे पर्टिकुलर एथनिक ग्रुप्स और पर्टिकुलर से कल्चर हैबिट्स एंड से लाइफ स्टाइल सो दिस देर इज़ अ प्रॉब्लम ऑफ मिक्सिंग विद अदर अदर पीपल सो हियर प्रॉब्लम इज विद द अदर अदर स्टेट्स एंड द प्रॉब्लम इज विद इन द स्टेट्स ऑल्सो बिकॉज एज आई सेड देर इन ए स्टेट देर आर सो मेनी एथनिक ग्रुप्स एंड इन द एथनिक ग्रुप्स दिस एथनिक ग्रुप्स स्पीक डिफरेंट लैंग्वेजेस एंड वन ग्रुप डज नॉट सपोर्ट द अदर लैंग्वेज और डज नॉट स्पीक द अदर लैंग्वेज और डज नॉट ट्राई टू स्पीक द अदर लैंग्वेज देन देर इज ए कंट्राडिक्शन एंड द नंबर ऑफ पीपल द पीपल लिविंग इन द नॉर्थ ईस्ट स्टेट्स इज वेरी फ्यू वेरी लेस कंपेयर टू द अदर स्टेट्स बिकॉज लाइक इन यूपी एंड आंध्र प्रदेश this they are very densely populated, very highly populated regions. And if we have a calculation, then the people from all over the northeastern regions, maybe the number may be equal to one big state like say UP, Uttar Pradesh, or say maybe or Punjab, or Andhra Pradesh, or Karnataka like this. So number one thing, very less people are there in this, are they confined in there, and very number of ethnicities are there, number of languages are there. So these are the, I mean, different perspective of differences among the Northeast region. Now, coming to the concept of the mainland country or the India, what happened here is India, the Northeast region geographically is a very porous region because this is exposed to one side, this is China is there, one side Bangladesh is there, Myanmar is there. So we have the people in this region, they are constantly facing problems, or this region is constantly facing problems from intrusions from the Chinese territory or from Bangladesh or Myanmar and these places. So most of the states in this region, the Northeast region, they are facing problems of intrusions from other states or from other countries. So they are exposed to that also. And because of this sparsely populated these things, or say different kind of ethnics, different kind of culturalism and languages, the concept of say the belongingness or the governance or the democracy or development is very far from understood in these countries. And if we study the Northeast regions, we should, I think we should study from the perspective of development. Because development is a center issue. I mean, this is related to the whole country. And the whole, I mean, the government of India is serious about the development process. Because if one country is developed, then we can become a economic power or developed country or powerful nation. So like say, for the last few years, we are claiming to be a permanent member in the Security Council of the United Nations. But see, again, we have in the international area, we have backdrops, we have problems, we have international politics. So if we can develop ourselves and we can become a strong economic power or nuclear power or as a, in a way that we are a developed country, then we can easily claim our seat in the United Nations Security Council. Because largely when we speak about the development of a country, it is the development of all the states of the country. But so far, by the diversity and these things, culturalism or different things, different factors, development in the Northeast region is something is a very very serious issue these days. So the central government also created a Department of Northeast Region, this DONER, for the development of the Northeast Region. So the central government, the Indian government, is also interested in the development of these regions. So because without developing these states in the Northeast Region, the development of the whole of the country is not possible. Like say, if we concentrate, the government concentrate only on say the New Delhi or the central India, then it is hardly a process of, a democratic process or process of development. So the government is taking steps for the development of these northeastern states. But there is it seems like it's a miscommunication between these states and the central government. Because all the states, states in the northeastern region, they are fighting a cause on some or the other pretext with the government of India, the central government. That is, some of the problems started from long back before independence, and some of the problems started after independence, and most of the problems are categorized as the ethnic problems in the Northeast region. Like say in the in Assam, Assam is again a state, it is very big state in the Northeast region. But this again, parts of it is exposed. This state is very close to Bangladesh, and Bangladesh, Assam has a problem of Bangladeshi intrusion, and again it also has problem from other, say like Arunachal again is a part which is exposed to the Chinese territory. So again, they have the problem of this intrusion. Again, right now this is a hot topic of intrusion of the Chinese into the country. So now, different states have different problems, and all the problems are not similar. That we can discuss when it comes to the, different states of the region. Now, the argument here is whether this the states of the northeastern regions of India are they neglected, lot, or the say they are taking it otherwise. Here we can keep a perspective that this is a very much part of the country. This is very much part of India, and by say kind of like say, some groups in this region, this Northeast region, their claim is to have a full independent state, like say Greater Nagaland. Then we have the problem of secessionism is there, because some of the states want to be an independent country or something like that. So there are many diverse problems in this region. But regarding the development, we cannot go to a problem, or we cannot go deep into a problem where there is most visibly there is or virtually there is no solution. So what we can do is we can think about the development of this region. So for the development of this region, what we can do is we can educate the people, or we can tell the people, or we can feel the people that we are very much part of the country, and we have equal rights for participant in the governance. So this is the question of democracy, because India is a democratic country, and when it comes to the democratic participation, there is so nothing like as we have discussed earlier, because this democracy is the best form of the government. So one has to participate. Then we are in a free and fair situation of democracy. So if once we become participatory in the democracy, then we can talk about the good governance. And as I said earlier, that everybody has the chance to participate in the governing process. Then there should be free and fair election. Then we have economic freedom. Then we have, which would have the economic freedom. Now, The problem in the Nordic region is every three aspects, the all the three aspects are seem to be lost somewhere, because like say there are governments in the states and they are participatory in the democratic process, and there are disruptions from other groups or say from ethnic groups or other groups, then there is a conflict between the governance and the other. Process that stalls democracy. So this is the main reason where violence erupts, or violence has become a way of life in the in this part of the region. And see, this is because of the lack of democratic procedure or democratic practice, then lack of development that leads to the violence. Here we can see, if we have a kind of say perspective here, that we can look into the matter very seriously, because as we already have discussed that this is a problem of communication. So media of a country, media of this country can play a role in the development of this states, or the restoration of democracy and development, sending the balance in this country. So what can media do? Because media, is an entity that has dedicated to the social upliftment, then social understanding, social education, and all kinds of these things. Although this is the social kind of entertainment, and commercialism is a part of the media, but media has a responsibility, because media all over the world is known as the fourth state. So media is also known as the watchdog, because media is a watchdog because it watches the three legs, that is judiciary, legislature, and this bureaucrats, executives of the democratic government. So if the government is lacking in the in conducting or in controlling or in the practice of democracy or development, then media can always tell the people, or if the problem is, if the lacuna is from the side of the people, then media can also play a role of telling the people that, okay, we are in such a democratic country, of course we are the biggest democracy in the world, as we are probably said. So we can tell the people, media can tell the people that, okay, we belong to a democratic country which is proud of being the biggest democracy. Then again, although say other countries of the developed countries, Western countries call us as India as a third world country or a developing country, the country is developing. Even now we are the president of the United Nations Security Council right now, and India contributed a lot in the world peace movement. Say example can be taken of the Indian peacekeeping force. Then India also played a role in the good role in the international politics, international nuclear policies. Then we have contributions in the First World War, the Second World War. So see, this is all possible because of being a democratic country, and the people of the country are actively participating in the democratic practices. So now the question of the development. This country is developing, but we have a far way to go. We are in the direction of development. We have far way to go because there are political problems. There are many other problems in this country. So this cannot be confined to a particular sector like the mainland India or something like that, because this is a problem of the whole country. And recently we have many setbacks in the political system, like we used to have the the bi-political party system, then we have now NDA, the kind of UPA, where multiple parties are grouped together and form the government. So now, what is a government? Government consists of the elected or representatives from the groups of people. Now, problem again, we can discuss in a way that the elected representatives from the people, this is less representation from the northeastern regions. So this we can take very seriously. We can talk about very seriously, because if we increase the number of say elected representatives, then there can be a voice in the central government, because the participation will be more, and there can be a more participation, then we can talk about the problems. We can highlight the problems, what are the problems in the northern regions, then there can be a solution, always a solution, way out of solving this problem, unlike the say problems in the states like Jammu and Kashmir, because where this involves other countries, I mean basically with the vested interests of other countries, so that is a separate issue. But there are some, from time to time, see, the governance is, see, we are, because of this say political participation problems or less number of elected representatives, so again there are problems still pertaining to the Northeast region. So like in some states we are talking about the say Armed Forces Special Power Act, for example. So government, there are governments in the Northeast region. There are 7 states, 8 states in the Northeast region. There are governments, but see, when it comes to the conflict of interest, then we, the government at the center should take a stand. Okay, what should be the solution like? But the active participation of government from the states is also required, because see, this is only between the this is an understanding between the governments at the center and at the states. So there is, then because we need to have good governments both at the center and both at the states. So in order to have a good government in the states, the people of the state, these three regions, they should take part in the democratic process, the free and fair election process, then they should take part in the economic development process, and therefore they should take part in the governance of the states. So then we can, the representation, the government of the states can obviously take the matter to the central government, and there is a there can be an understanding. So like the case in the with the NSCN in one of the states of these regions, like they have a ceasefire, so we can, they can always be talk out, or there can always be a room for talk out the problems. There are we are here, we can discuss about some of the problems in the Northeast different regions, because we start from Assam, because obviously this is the biggest state in the region. So the problem with Assam, the kind of militancy, they like there are active militant organizations like ULFA, then you have Bodo Group, then these are active groups in the Northeast region. Again, see here, they are, what are they demanding from the state or from the country or from the central government? See, as this is very obvious, because they are ULFA, for example, it started in 1979 with as armed insurgents. So what happened in 1979, this is long way back, and this is the age of the second millennium, 2000 and after. Now if still the problem persists, then see, this is because the lack of understanding between the center and the state, or there can be talks out like the NSN have done. So there can be tripartite talks, like the states can be involved, the parties can be involved, central government can be involved. So there can be like this. I mean, there can be a way of seizing the violence, or there can be always a way of for the democratic processes. Then obviously there can be a process of development in the region. So now we are talking as a whole to sum up, to conclude this, because the problem in this Northeast region should be it starts from, there should be a guideline, right? Like it starts from the whole, I mean, restart, reaffirm फ्रॉम डेवलपिंग और इंट्रोड्यूसिंग द डेमोक्रेसी इन दिस रीजन, बिकॉज पीपल हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड, पीपल हैव टू बी पार्टिसिपेटिव, पीपल हैव टू टेक रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी, पीपल हैव टू नो देयर राइट्स, पीपल हैव टू एक्सरसाइज देयर राइट्स एज वेल, देयर फ्रीडम ऑफ स्पीच, फ्रीडम ऑफ प्रॉपर्टी, फ्रीडम ऑफ लिविंग, ऑल काइंड ऑफ राइट्स दे हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड. सो द नंबर वन थिंग दैट इज रिक्वायर्ड इन द नॉर्थ ईस्ट रीजन इज द रेस्टोरेशन ऑफ डेमोक्रेसी, बिकॉज मोस्ट ऑफ द प्रॉब्लम्स आर मोस्ट लाइकली इरप्टेड और स्टार्टेड फ्रॉम द लैक ऑफ डेमोक्रेसी और पीपल्स मिसअंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ डेमोक्रेसी और पीपल्स से इंटरेस्ट और वेस्टेड इंटरेस्ट फॉर नॉट पार्टिसिपेटिंग इन द डेमोक्रेटिक प्रोसेस. देन वेन इट बिकम्स, आई मीन वी गेट द पीपल गेट द डेमोक्रेटिक राइट्स, डेमोक्रेटिक फ्रीडम, देन पीपल ऑटोमेटिकली थिंक्स अबाउट द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ ए प्लेस, ऑफ ए कंट्री, ऑफ ए रीजन. सो वंस वी आर डेमोक्रेटाइज, द रीजन इज डेमोक्रेटाइज, एंड वंस द डेवलपमेंट प्रोसेस स्टार्ट्स, टू माई माइंड द वायलेंस इन दिस एरियाज और दिस रीजन्स कैन बी installed. So this was what it is.
Okay, well, you discuss all the things, what are the causes, what are the opportunity they have with growing democracy and the opportunity of development. But one thing which come first to the mind, in the beginning there was problem of identity, but now they feel more integrated to the India than their identity, keeping a few people in the say they are thinking against this line, but most of the people feel integrated.
You are very right.
So this changes, how did this came into
very
being?
Very very nice proposition from your side, sir.
Yeah.
We can look back to the educational policy, educational changes in the last say two decades, say starting from the say 1986 policy of education. See, people of these regions, the Nordic regions, they are going out to other states where there is an opportunity of education. Then they get the education from there and try to apply what they have learned or they have educated, and they are also exposed to the other world by way of education. Because see, in this day you will find, you take any country, I mean any educational institute in India, and you will find the people from the Northeast, because they are more interested in education. So once they come out from the particular this states, the so-called cocoons, so they can say
they
have
come
the,
to know others,
yeah,
culture,
they come
society
to know, yeah, then they can easily mix with that once they know, once they are educated. So this is one contribution. This education is one contribution where you have say development of say many things, economic development, language development, social development, and these things. Because this ethnicity, they come to know other groups also.
Right.
So this is, I mean, partly contributory to the education system.
You have been from there. You studied outside the Northeast regions,
yes,
and working as a professor in different states.
Yes.
So what is your personal experience? What you like to tell to the Northeast people that this is the India, this is what I witnessed, I felt, my ears is this. What is your own?
As I say, as the citizen of this region, and as a I feel very proud I belong to this region, Northeast region. But when I came out to study, and my experience before my postgraduate studies or say doctoral studies, whatever, it was very different, because there is a basically how we grow up in our day-to-day life, how we grow up in my own place, and then how we grow up in a different state, I mean, or different city or different place. So this is very, 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 very different, entirely different. And as I have seen the cultures of, say, people from Haryana, people from Punjab, this is basically the problem of communication is there. This is the communication process, because in these regions, Northeast regions, there is a, आई मीन डिफ लैकिंग और से हाईली वांटेड सिचुएशन ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन इन दिस रीजन बिकॉज पीपल डू नॉट कम्युनिकेट फ्रॉम अदर ग्रुप्स टू और से लाइक इवन इन द फैमिली ऑल्सो लाइक सी वी सी ओके वी हैव द रेस्पेक्ट फॉर आवर एल्डर पीपल एल्डर्स वी हैव ग्रांड फादर्स ग्रांड मदर्स वी हैव दिस थिंग्स बट वी फेल टू कम्युनिकेट वॉट वी वॉन्ट टू डू and they also fail to communicate what they want from us. So it starts from our family. Because
the kind of system that
yeah,
is
kind of system
coming way. Generation to generation.
Yes, yes. So and what I have seen is there is a loss of communication. So this is very required because there should be a communication process. Then if there is a communication process, then a family can be developed. Because we can plan together, we can sit together, and we can think about, okay, what will be the future of this family, and what we can do for the family. Then one family can be developed by the through process of communication. But there is something what I have seen in these regions that we fail to communicate, even in our
okay, when you compare with. So it's
yeah.
not a problem of one region to another region.
Yeah.
It's a general in the nature of the people.
Nature of the people.
That they are less communicative, less...
Yeah.
Feel to communicate with others,
yeah, yeah.
a kind of
belongingness.
Yes. So that need to be developed. So I think with with education and awareness that has come up, and with that's why a kind of another feeling.
Yeah, it's coming up.
Second thing, as far as the development is concerned, yeah. how much you are satisfied when you see the Northeast region. Nowadays, and
yeah.
it was 10 years back when you had seen that.
Yeah.
How the changes has
development in these regions, Northeast region. This is, to my understanding, this is not much as required also, because there is a very big room of development. Because see, this region is not politically developed. As I said, see, we have my state, for example, there is a population of say 15 to 20 lakhs, for example, right? And we have one representative, that is to the Lok Sabha.
Okay.
So this place is we have an inner representative, then we have an outer representative, again which are incommunicando, this in between these two. So what happened here is we have only one representative, and only one representative in a house of say 500 plus. MPs, there is no room for say listening to others or placing to other MPs. So we need to develop these regions politically, so that more and more people
come
as,
to the
as participants, yeah, to the parliamentary process or say whatever. So then people see there can be more. Scope for development.
More politically,
yeah, more politically. It should be more politically developed.
But having come to the communication era, we find that the voice is being heard more, more assertively and more emphatically, because the number of channel has come up,
yeah.
number of newspaper.
You are very right.
So that it depends. Not the number, it's the quality of voice which is required to be heard.
Yes, yes. So there is the question of Armed Forces Special Power Act in two states of North. So
that is Armed Forces program. That is only kind of exploitative nature. It has been exploited by the media.
Yeah.
What is your take?
Still, there is a problem. Like say in the, I have seen the media in the northern region. Like even the Times of India, one of the exemplary newspaper of this country, and then we have Hindustan Times, but this and other channels as well, because they fail to report, or they are reporting very less from this region, and they are also afraid to send their people in these regions, because there are again many problems relating to this terrorism, so they are one step back. On the reporting of these regions, so again there are so many problems where they are not going, and there is a reason for why they are not going also, because their interest or their culture or the language is particularly restricted to the northern regions, and in order to go to these regions, they have to learn the languages, then learn the culture of the people. So this is something lacking for the from the side of the media, because media for a country is a very powerful tool, and but for India, this unfortunately media has to go a long way.
It also need to go deeper into
yes.
the masses,
yeah,
deeper into the different corner of the country.
Like in 1996,
not only
I,
top to down the message should come, but also down to top.
No, like I studied in 1996
okay.
about the media contents, how the media of the country are reporting the notice. So I have a comparison with Jammu and Kashmir and other parts of the country with the these things, these seven states. So what I found was only a mere some 1.25% is reported, I mean, by the media for this region. And when around 25 to 27% are reported from Jammu and Kashmir. So
much higher.
Yeah, much higher, because media is concentrated only on one side, and they are not taking up the
maybe
issue.
It's because of the events that has been that has brought the, it's not the region centric media, I think.
No, actually there are so many unreported events in these states. It may be the conflicts, it may be the political process.
I mean the events which have of major magnitude that has been, that's that is the where interest of the media lies. It's not the importance, lesser
yeah.
importance.
Yeah,
that's why they focus more on the
right.
Jammu Kashmir than the this region, northeast
yeah.
regions.
Yeah.
So now the point is, we are in this stage. We find now a number of changes has occurred, number of things are going on, happening, and vibrant democracy, good governance, developments, and but still there are some people who feel unhappy.
Right.
So what need to be done
right.
to keep keeping them into the view to make them mend the ways?
This is a very very pertinent question, I think. But this kinds of say kind of you can call say vested interest
mm-hmm.
or say people who are opposing the democratic process, this is I think I mean I don't think this is a problem with the notice only, because these things are there in other states also. These are more visible in other states. But this is I mean it may be not proper to say that this is a characteristics of northeastern region only,
mm-hmm.
because there are say other say like in Jharkhand, say like in Bihar,
mm-hmm.
and say other states.
No, it's true.
There are
more
many,
or more or less all the states
yes,
are inflicted
yes,
with such
more or less
things.
All the states.
All the
states
are inflicted
yeah.
with such things. But
yes,
you
yes.
are a media expert also. So how a mass media can change this thinking, change this attitude?
Actually, our media, Indian media, is so diverse again, the people of the country. The media is so diverse, so they have different interests.
Mm-hmm.
And these days, media is not taking its interest in the development process. But you take the media of other countries, like the American media, they have always an American interest. If you talk about the media in America, if you talk about media in United Kingdom, they have always their own country's interest. But here, problem is, we are more commercialized, then we are more...
And they have interest only in a story.
Yes,
mm-hmm.
only in the kind of stories that, which is not, I mean, sensible even...
Yeah, stories
of,
they are
yeah.
intending to make.
And very insensitive to the development process, because development is very less reporting in the media.
Okay. Have you any studies been done on this issue?
Yeah.
To what extent the development has been reported over the years?
No, there are so many studies conducted in this, because see, because this can be confirmed from the contents of the media,
mm-hmm.
how and how they are reporting. Because like the news reporting, for example, as we have seen, so many channels are there, and they are in a race to grab the first opportunity to tell something. But they are not particularly digging into the development of these things. But see, they are more interested in the breaking news because we have a culture of breaking news disease, and anything can be a breaking news. What they like.
How do you see the reporting in India? When we say that journalists are not only supposed to give news which people want to know, but also what people need to know. On this artistry, have they been successful? Are they thinking on this line or not?
Here we have another problem here, because media these days is not a social entity or something like that. These are bound by the market forces.
Mm-hmm.
So this has become a profession. So we have many MNCs, and we have our media is surviving, or the government is surviving on FDIs, mm-hmm. this is the foreign direct investments. Mm-hmm. So the interest lies somewhere else, because there are forces, and they have to oblige to their.
You have rightly pointed out the market.
Yes.
So what is the scenario of market in the Northeast?
Yes. Media market.
Not media market, general market.
General market, okay, see.
Mall, etc.,
right.
Big markets,
right.
They have taken over the local market. Yeah, still
right.
A kind of conflict is there also.
Right.
Because in metro we find that malls are dominated everywhere.
Right.
The people who were on the street still say are now at stake. So
right.
What is the situation in the Northeast region?
Right. Traditionally, in Northeast region, say like there is a open trade
mm-hmm.
between India and Burma, and there is a border. This is called the cross-border trade.
Mm-hmm.
So there was open for some time now. The privatization is there.
Mm-hmm.
Though the privatization is widely practiced in Northeast region,
okay.
But problem is again see this the so-called big companies or say MNCs,
mm-hmm.
they cannot come and operate in the Northeast region because of the terrorist problem. The terrorism is there.
So they are fear for the.
They are afraid to trade in these
okay.
regions. So this is one backdrop, one handicap in the.
That's why the major,
major
big companies are not there.
Right,
what about the people's attitude toward the these companies or the products which are being flooded on the screen of the television,
yeah.
which allure the people. What are the people's attitude there?
There are two things here. Like say, now we are talking about two generations. There is a generation gap.
Generation. Okay.
The older generation,
mm-hmm.
they are quality conscious, and they are very quite traditional. So they always react to the new companies. Because we are traditionally born up, bring up, and we are traditionally doing everything.
Mm-hmm.
And there is a challenge by the new trade, new market or new companies. So this is one way. And the other way is the new generation, where they are highly appreciate of these companies and the products they are bringing in.
Mm-hmm.
Because they are into a new kind of lifestyles.
Mm-hmm.
So there is a conflict again
mm-hmm.
here also. Between the generations, the older and the new generations.
Okay, the last question I would like to ask you.
Yes.
10 years hence, how you see the Northeast region will unfold itself?
So far as I understand, of that now, of these days,
mm-hmm.
Northeast, all the Northeast states,
mm-hmm.
they are developing, and they can overtake other states in the next 10 years, the coming 10 years, because they are developing technologically as well. Science and technology, they are developing very well.
Mm-hmm.
There are many creative people who also writes, who also does things. Culturally, this country, this part of the region is a very
rich,
highly rich region.
Mm-hmm.
And languages, their exposure to the external world, this is also very high. So in the coming years, as I understand,
mm-hmm.
Notice can go a long way.
Okay. So, well, friends, it's a very positive signs what Dr. Sushil K. Singh said, that Northeast is having bright future and is on the right path, and the number of factors that has प्लेड इम्पोर्टेंट रोल एंड मोटिवेटेड द इंटायर रीजन टू रीच टू अ न्यू हाइट, टू टेक अ न्यू एंड एज्यूम ए न्यू रोल्स इन द स्ट्रेंथिंग ऑफ डेमोक्रेसी इन द डेवलपमेंट एंड ऑल्सो मिटिगेटिंग वायलेंस. सो दिस वे वॉट वी फोरसी फ्रॉम हेयर दैट गुड फ्यूचर अहेड फॉर द नॉर्थ ईस्ट रीजन एंड ऑल्सो फॉर द इंटायर कंट्री वॉट वी कैन get from the today lectures. So with this hope, I hope the lecture must have benefited all of you. I thank all of you for watching the lecture, and on your behalf, I thank Dr. Sushil K. Singh for enlightening us what is happening on these fronts in the Northeast region. Thank you very much.